Occasionally, when working with rational equations, you'll end up with something called an extraneous solution. Because we're working with fractions, the denominator cannot be zero. In example one, we again follow the same process that we have been following so far by factoring the trinomial in the denominator. And once again, just because these are always factoring to the same as these other denominators and the other terms in this equation doesn't mean that will always be the case. So my LCD is x minus 8, x minus 4. I'll go through and multiply each term by x minus 8, x minus 4. Now that I've multiplied through, I can divide out the common factors. Now that they've divided out, my new equation, or my equation without denominators, looks like this. X times x minus 4 minus 2 times x minus 8 equals negative 3x plus 56. Now that I've rewritten my equation without denominators, I can distribute and get all my terms. X squared minus 4x minus 2x plus 16 equals negative 3x plus 56. Since this will be quadratic in form, I will set my equation equal to 0 by adding 3x to both sides and subtracting 56 from both sides. I now have x squared minus x minus 2x minus 40 equals 0. Adding like terms, I get x squared minus 3x minus 40 equals 0. This factors 2x minus 8 and x plus 5. From here I set my factors equal to 0 and solve for x. X equals 8 and x equals negative 5. Here is where it changes. We have to check for extraneous solutions. When we do that, we take the values that we've found for x and plug them in or substitute them into our denominators. Notice that wherever there's an x minus 8, if we were to plug 8 in for x, we would get 0 in the denominator. Because of that, our fractions would be undefined. If they're undefined, that is not a solution. That is an extraneous solution, and so we have to throw the extraneous solutions out. So the only solution that we can keep at this point is x equal to negative 5. Let's try this in example 2. Our LCD is going to be most likely x minus 2, x minus 4, but let's go ahead and factor the trinomial just to make sure. X minus 2, x minus 4 will indeed give me this trinomial. So my LCD is x minus 2, x minus 4. multiplying that LCD to each term in my equation gives me the following. Notice now that I can divide out my common factors from each term. I'll now rewrite my equation now that I've cleared my fractions. X times x minus 4 plus 2 times x minus 2 equals 4x minus 12. From here, we'll distribute the factors outside parentheses to give us all our terms, x squared minus 4x plus 2x minus 4 equals 4x minus 12. Before I set this equal to 0, I'm going to add like terms. This gives me x squared minus 2x minus 4 equals 4x minus 12. From here, I'm going to set my equation equal to 0 by subtracting 4x from both sides and adding 12 to both sides. This will give me a quadratic equation, x squared minus 6x plus 8 equals 0. When I factor this, my factors are x minus 4, x minus 2 equals 0. Setting the factors equal to 0, my solutions for x are x equals 4 and x equals 2. When I look for extraneous solutions, I have to take the value for x and substitute it in for x in the denominators to check to see if any of them will make the denominator 0. If I plug 4 in, that would give me a 2 here, but a 0 here. So I have to throw out that extraneous solution. Now let's check 2. If I plug 2 in here, that would also give me 0. So there are no solutions for this other than extraneous solutions. So neither of these would work as solutions. You would write no solution. For this rational equation.